SpaceX and the new era of space exploration. As humanity entered the 21st century and a new millennium, Elon Musk was envisioning something big for humanity. In 2001, Musk had an idea to land a mini greenhouse on Mars with dehydrated gel and seeds, dubbed the Mars Oasis. The purpose was to see if plants could grow in the soil on Mars. This idea would eventually become what we know today as SpaceX. Ever since the moon landing in 1969, the public's interest in space exploration has been on the decline. There were raising concerns about how the taxpayers' money was being used to fund a futile endeavor. The often-cited story of US taxpayers wasting millions of dollars on a ballpoint pen that can write in zero gravity, instead of the practical choice, a pencil, is often used to show how pointless the space program is. Elon Musk was seeking to change it. The Mars Oasis mission he envisioned was supposed to be a philanthropic mission. Seeing life from the Earth being sent and grown in another planet would surely get the public excited again about the prospect of space exploration. The goal was to garner more excitement from Congress so that they would appropriate more money and increase NASA's budget. The end goal was for humanity to set foot in Mars. And to do that, Elon was prepared to lose half of the $175 million that he got from the sale of PayPal. What fueled this crazy vision was the dream he had since he was young. Even though he was born 2 years after the moon landing, Elon was truly inspired by that event. And he was expecting, hoping, that humanity would continue beyond Apollo 11. He was dreaming of a base on the moon, sending people to Mars, and even to the moons of Jupiter. Trying to realize that dream, Elon went in search of a rocket to execute the Mars Oasis mission. He couldn't afford the American rockets as they were too expensive. Meanwhile, in Russia, they were decommissioning a whole bunch of intercontinental ballistic missiles. So, Elon went to Russia in 2001 and early 2002 to buy some decommissioned ICBMs. However, they kept raising the price on him, making them too expensive for him to purchase. That was when he came to realize that even if they doubled NASA's budget, they would still not make progress, because it would all be spent on expendable rockets. While they might reach Mars, Elon feared that it would be the same result as the moon mission, just leaving flags and footprints on Mars and never going back again. It was not what he wanted to achieve. So, Elon tried to look for alternatives. To realize what he wanted to achieve, they needed affordable rockets. He then noticed that he could start a company to build the affordable rockets he needed. Elon calculated that the raw materials for building a rocket actually were only 3% of the sales price of a rocket, at the time. By controlling most of the supply chain of the materials and applying the modular approach from software engineering, his company could cut the launch price of a rocket to 10% of its market price and still have a 70% gross margin. Elon then proceeded to found SpaceX. It was a passion project worth tens of millions of dollars. Elon didn't let anyone invest in SpaceX in the beginning because he thought that it had around a 90% chance to fail. After all, the rocket industry was a literal billion-dollar business and Elon was coming in with less than $100 million. It used to cost NASA $1.6 billion per launch. Elon's capital, although seemed large to the average people, was actually tiny in comparison. It wasn't even 10% of the average NASA's launch cost. To resolve the problem of the lack of capital, Elon turned to his software engineering background. In software engineering, there is a thing called a minimum viable product, or MVP for short. It is a version of a software with just enough features to be usable by early customers who can then provide feedback for future development. Elon tried to apply this concept to SpaceX and tried to build the smallest useful orbital rocket instead of building a more complex and riskier one, which would have bankrupted the company. This first rocket would be named Falcon 1, a nod to Star Wars' Millennium Falcon. Falcon 1 would only carry around half a ton to orbit. Elon had planned for Falcon 1 to launch in November 2003, just 15 months after SpaceX started. The date of its first launch would be pushed back by almost 3 years, to March 2006. The first launch ended in failure less than a minute into the flight because of a fuel line leak and subsequent fire. The next two launches also ended up in failure. It wasn't until the fourth launch on September 2008 that Falcon 1 finally reached the low Earth orbit. However, it wasn't all roses and sunshine at SpaceX. The company, like Elon's other company, Tesla, was facing a major cash shortage. SpaceX had the expensive Falcon 9 efforts to support, as well as the construction of the Dragon capsule, which would take supplies and eventually humans to the International Space Station. In reality, either project would have cost more than $1 billion individually, but SpaceX needed to find a way to build both machines at once for less money. The company had also rapidly increased its hiring rate and moved into a significantly larger headquarters. However, even with all of this progression, SpaceX still struggled to make payroll. They had a commercial flight booked that would carry a satellite into orbit for the Malaysian government, but the launch wouldn't occur until 2009 and they wouldn't receive payment until then. So in the meantime, they were simply trying to keep their business afloat financially. Just when SpaceX learned how to fly one of its rockets successfully, it was headed for bankruptcy. Luckily for Elon, he found out in December 2008 that NASA was close to awarding a contract to resupply the space station. SpaceX's fourth launch had qualified it to receive some of this money, which was more than $1 billion. Musk contacted people in Washington and discovered that SpaceX might even be the leading candidate for the deal, thanks to their low launch price. And on December 23, 2008, SpaceX won the $1.6 billion contract for 12 NASA resupply flights to the space station. That deal saved both SpaceX and Tesla from bankruptcy. The company has gone from strength to strength since then, growing from 500 employees in 2008 to 5,000 employees in 2016. It has completed the Falcon 9 and Dragon projects and has been launching rockets to space on a monthly basis. It has achieved numerous achievements, including being the first private company to send humans into orbit in its Crew Dragon spacecraft on May 30, 2020. However, this is just the start for SpaceX. Being a visionary, Elon Musk has grand plans for the company. The ultimate goal is still to send humans to Mars and colonize the planet. In a 2011 interview, Elon said that he hopes to send humans to Mars' surface within 10 to 20 years. Although we are past the 10 years mark since that interview, there is still time to achieve it before 2031. To achieve this grand ambition, Elon has another shorter-term goal for his company, which is to improve the cost and reliability of access to space. If a Mars mission is to succeed, they will need to send multiple spacecrafts going back and forth between Earth and Mars. He can't just do another repeat of the moon landing. That's why launch cost is a big concern. If each launch cost an enormous amount of money, it would be a huge financial burden on the company. SpaceX has to find a way to reduce the cost. A major goal of SpaceX has been to develop a rapidly reusable launch system. The current price per launch for a SpaceX rocket is around $50 to $70 million. While it's much cheaper than their competitors, getting the reusable technology right could cut this price by a factor of 10. $5 to $7 million per launch would change things for the space industry dramatically. The cost of building a rocket and an airplane is not that much different from one another. But why is it much cheaper to ride on an airplane than in a rocket? That's because airline companies don't just use their planes once and discard them. They can use the same airplane for thousands of flights, so the cost can be spread across the thousands of takeoffs. In short, it is reusable. That's not the case with rockets. Due to the extreme condition they face when going into and back from outer space, they suffer from greater tear and wear. Although SpaceX has achieved partial reusability for its rocket parts, it hasn't achieved full reusability. If they can reuse the entire rocket for multiple launches without significant maintenance costs, the launch cost would reduce significantly. It can open up a new era of space tourism and Mars colonization. In March 2014, COO Gwynne Shotwell said that once the Falcon Heavy and Dragon 2 crew versions are operational, her company's engineering team will focus on developing technology to support the transport infrastructure necessary for Mars missions. In August 2020, SpaceX indicated it was looking to build a resort in South Texas with the intent to turn Boca Chica into a 21st century spaceport. While he's been surrounded by more controversies as of late, in part due to his enormous success, there's no doubt in Elon Musk's passion to turn humanity into a spacefaring civilization. The people at SpaceX are working hard to turn that dream into reality. And the crazy thing is, it looks like they might succeed in the near future. Thank you for watching. Tell us what you think about Elon and SpaceX in the comments section below. Click the like button and share if you enjoyed this video. Subscribe for more videos like this one. See you in another video.